This is the Lawrence County SportsNet, powered by LCAP.
About to bring gold back to Lawrence County.
Your home for the County of Champions.
And how sweet it is! A state gold medal for the Union Scotties!
And the Shannock Lancers are your 2A softball champions. The trophy lifted high.
The 10th seed Union Scotties are WPIAL champions.
Not a Cinderella story, a championship story here.
And your 2023 WPIL 2A girls champions, the Shenango Wildcats.
The pitch from Bruce, here it comes. Look at this! Union wins it! Union Scotties have rallied to win the WPIAL championship.
The top local athletes and the top sports moments all featured here, live or archived, at lcsportsnet.com.
Down inside and alley-oop the dunk. Good.
She'll strike it and score.
Featuring over 100 broadcasts of county events in over a dozen sports. Your voice for Lawrence County sports.
The gold ball headed home to Newcastle.
This is the Lawrence County SportsNet.
Thank you for calling Axe. Where can we take you today?
To work, to the store, to Grandma's house. Axe can get you there, but it's much more than a ride. It's a joyride.
I'm helping people. I'm getting them out of their house. I'm taking them to their doctors, to the grocery store.
They say I'm entertaining. Okay, we laugh, we joke, we sing, we tell stories.
They're like family to us.
Even if it's the same day, to schedule your joyride, call Axe today.
And you are looking live from Mohawk High School, the turf here at MHS, for some WPIAL Section 1 Class 3A baseball action as the Mohawk Warriors take on the Ellwood City Wolverines. Game 2 of the series, game 1 yesterday down at Sanders Field at Ewing Park. A 6-1 victory for Mohawk as they come into today's game. Still undefeated in section play at 5-0, Ellwood City with a 1-5 mark in section play. I'm James Dotson, along for the ride. Glad to be here with you yet again here at Mohawk High School. Excuse me, give a shout out to Matthew Flannery, our producer extraordinaire here this afternoon on a beautiful day here at the turf. As you see teams out there getting their final instructions, let's look at yesterday's game between the Wolverines and Mohawk Warriors. Ellwood able to get a lead early, a 1-0 lead after two innings of play, but Mohawk 3-4, 1-5, and 2-6 to put it out of reach, and really with 8 hits for Mohawk, just 3 for Ellwood City. And that's kind of been the name of the game, unfortunately, for Ellwood all year long, has been the hitting or lack thereof over the course of this season. As a whole, the team batting just .204 coming into this game. And you're going to hear a lot of averages that are none too pleasant, but keep in mind that they've played a pretty tough schedule here to start the year. Have the Ellwood City Wolverines. You look at the fact that you have, you know, non-conference games against a pretty good Burgettstown team, Newcastle, a 5A opponent, and they start right away in section play with doubleheaders against Riverside and Quake Valley in a tight game. They have a pretty good pitching staff there with Quaker Valley there as well. Last series they played was against Neshannock and now against Mohawk, and this is just a grind of a section, to put it lightly. Mohawk mentioned at 5-0. They're right now a half game ahead of Riverside. Riverside having their off week this week in the way the schedule worked out. They do not have their section doubleheader Monday, Tuesday scheduled for this week. They'll pick it back up next week. Shenango at 3-2. They defeated Quaker Valley yesterday. Quaker Valley at 2-4. Neshannock at 2-2. They're still playing catch up in terms of their games being played in section play. They play against Beaver Falls again today. Ellwood City at 1-5 again coming into today's contest. As we get ready for our starting lineups and our national anthem, we'll talk a little bit about the teams and their starting lineups here momentarily, but wanted to give a big shout out again to everybody watching, everybody listening if you're on Game Changer or watching on Facebook Live, watching as well on our website on YouTube. Plenty of places to find us. Gotta love it here on Lawrence County SportsNet, and especially with our friends with the Trib Live High School Sports Network as well. And the big thing, too, about yesterday's game is the fact that, well, I guess the best way to put it, too, offensively causing issues, but causing havoc on the other side, Mohawk. Not only did they have 8 hits, they also had 8 stolen bases in yesterday's game. We'll get into it with the Ellwood City defense when it comes up, but they flipped things around. Ryan Widmeyer is going to be up behind the dish today. Jordan Keller going to be playing second base. So I think that's a part of two, is just trying something different to try to find a new way to make things work. That's all you can ask for, I guess, and trying to find anything to slow down those Warrior runners. We're going to pause now for the playing of our national anthem. Your national anthem there, performed by Caden Butch. It's kind of become a little bit of a theme here at Mohawk High School. We absolutely love every minute of it. We're just about ready to get things underway, so let's take a look first at our starting lineups. We'll start with our Dorn Concrete batting order for Ellwood City. You see it up there on your screen. Jacob Biscuit back in the leadoff role. Isaiah Lutz jumping down into the two spot. Jordan Keller, Aaron Lake, at the 3-4 spot as they've been all year. Gordon Boker hitting fifth. Nardone, Widmeyer, Kennedy, and Landis rounding out the batting order for Ellwood City. Your starting lineup's brought to you by Doran Concrete, laying the foundation for your business. Don't just let anyone lay down the foundation for your home or business. Visit DoranConcrete.com for your free estimate. Today, the DH Boker is hitting for the center fielder, Mikael Cuevas. Let's take a look now at our defensive alignment. It's brought to you by Madur Bonner Law. Have the best defense behind you with a community firm with personalized connection and individualized service. Your Madur Bonner Law defensive alignment on your screen. You see in the outfield from left to right, Hoppers in the corners, Mason and Keegan with Nail sandwiched in between, Pizzullo, Rona, Fadden, and Chapman left to right across the infield. AJ Verdi behind the dish, and at on the hill, I should say, is Briar Crawford. Another sophomore pitcher, Vinny Pizzullo, the sophomore, went yesterday, threw for 2 hits. How about Briar Crawford? Got a save on the year, a 1-0 record, 21 strikeouts and 10 walks, and 11 and two-thirds innings pitched. And this is the number I like, just over one on the whip, a 1.15. He actually had 5 innings of no-hit baseball in the second game against Neshanic. He's done a great job in his work on the mound so far this year, as has this entire Mohawk team. When you talk to Coach Mariano, all he says is, hey, our guys are going to compete, our guys are going to throw strikes, that's all we ask for, and that's what they do the best. And that's what's going to be key for them, not only today, but throughout the entirety of this game. Beautiful weather, though I'm told don't get used to it. Yeah, Matt LaPorte looking at me like, yeah, don't remind me here. At least he's got the turf all ready to go. How many people have been calling you about trying to play on the turf up here, especially the softball field, being full turf? I can only imagine. Hey, much better than the rainouts that we've had the last few years, especially with the old softball field. Love what they've done, dude, but however, I got to get this out of the way right now. You shouldn't be here, sir. You got ejected at the last game, did Mr. LaPorte. Matt LaPorte, the athletic director here at Mohawk, he was the former baseball coach at Ambridge. Well, Ambridge's new head coach got ejected from the game. But in the report, it mentioned Matt LaPorte as being the one who needed to be ejected and have the 2-game suspension. So I don't know how exactly that works there, but we are glad to have him here in a fun little story. I can only imagine the phone calls you were receiving at that one, for sure. as we get ready to start today's ball game. Head coach Chris Wise in his fourth year for Ellwood City. He will be coaching down at third. Brad Welsh coaching down at first base. Here to get things underway. First pitch coming up. Your first pitch delivery today is brought to you by Penn Ohio Bottled Water. Let Penn Ohio Bottled Water do the heavy lifting and deliver refreshing water straight to your door. Leading off will be Jacob Biscup, left fielder, moving up to the leadoff spot. 0 for 1 yesterday, but on base a couple of times. And there's your first pitch, a swing and a miss. Time of your first pitch, 4:35 here this evening. As Crawford rocks, fires. This one's drilled out towards left field over the head of the third baseman, Vinny Pizzullo, for a leadoff single. Good start to the game right there. Again, only three hits yesterday for Ellwood City, but starting off strong there. Multitude of games going on here today. I think the only team that is not playing today is Mohawk softball and Union baseball. Union, like Riverside, we mentioned, having their off week. Crawford. This one bunted down by Isaiah Lutz. Going to be taken by Crawford. Throw to first is high, but able to get back is Chapman. Sacrifice does the job, though, for Lutz. Sacrifice 1-3 moves Biscup to second base. And that'll bring up the three-hitter Jordan Keller. Jordan Keller coming in. 182 hitter on the year, the sophomore. Leads the team in the category that most catchers do, getting hit by a pitch. Three times he's been plunked on the season. So again, he is not the catcher today. He will be playing second base, so he'll also run for himself, though he normally does anyway. Very rarely does he get a courtesy runner. Breaking ball misses high and away for ball one. This game, I think, you don't want to say a must-win scenario for Ellwood City, as they've had basically the toughest stretch just about that you can think with this section to start the year. But at the same time, need a little momentum to be going through as this one misses downstairs. 2-0 the count to Keller. Not to mention, I mean, these two teams obviously have battled football field many times in the gymnasium playing a many great games basketball-wise, including the state playoff game, first state playoff game ever between two Lawrence County foes. Mohawk, overall, felt like they've kind of had Ellwood's number. We'll see how this one plays out over the course of today. The 2-1 from Crawford. Fouled off down the right field line, out of play. Count now 2-2. Also want to mention Joseph Roth. He is back in the, was back yesterday, I should say, back in the lineup. Can't believe the unfortunate scenario that he had. 2-2 breaking ball taken back in. One hop by the second baseman. Could play Bobby Fadden to get the out. Maybe an early Maley Chiropractic play of the game nomination there. Runner will advance to third, but a nice backhand on a tough shot. Two hard hit balls, but now two down. As Aaron Lake will come to the plate. First pitch misses high and away for ball one. .74 and sunny. Gotta love it. Here at Mohawk, 2-0. This one misses downstairs. Again, brand new turf this season here at Mohawk. Turf infield, still grass outfield. Outfield hanging in there with all the rain as best as possible. Still pretty wet out by the fence. especially in right center. 2-0 pitch, catches the block on the inner half. Count now 2-1. Shenango at Quaker Valley today. Beaver Falls at Neshannock. That game's going to be at 5 o'clock. Explain that one in a moment as this one misses outside. 3-1 now the count. Newcastle, because Flaherty Field has had trouble getting games in, well, they moved their game to Neshannock. So that game started at 3, their game against Mars. And then Neshannock against Beaver Falls in their second game of the doubleheader will take place after that, about 5 o'clock. 3-1 pitch here, misses down to the Pebbles. 2-out walk drawn by Lake, and that'll bring D.H. Gordon Boker to the plate. Boker, just his 6th plate appearance on the season. First and third, looks like Verdi's going to give the signals out. Both these teams so fundamentally sound. You know that they have multiple plays in these first to third situations, and on the base paths, many different types of steals as well. As this one's downstairs, good block by Verdi behind the dish. 1-0 the count. The 1-0 from Crawford. This one's off the end of the bat and foul back. Look, he took something off of that one. Evens the count at 1-1. One pitch, misses upstairs, runner goes, fake the throw, that will allow the stolen base by Lake. Ball on the pitch, so 2-1 the count. Boker with two ducks on the pond. Now Crawford looks like he's gonna go from the windup now with two men on, and this one's a sinking liner, but caught there by Vinny Pizzullo to end the inning. Two runners left on the bags. We've played a half inning. Ellwood City 0, Mohawk coming up to bat. So let's flip the script and keep it right here. We'll take a look at the starting batting order. Again, your starting lineup's brought to you by Door and Concrete. There's your batting order for the Mohawk Warriors. And same that we've seen throughout most of it. Good to see Mason Hopper, though, back in the starting lineup. Missed some time with a tweaked knee. They were worried about it. It could have been a little more severe, but ended up being not too bad. He's back in there, and that 7-8-9 combo, Hopper, Nail, and Hopper have been a dangerous combination, turning it over to the top. And when you have a YSU commit and a Cal U commit hitting second and third, a dangerous lineup all the way through the order, I guess, is probably a better way to look at it. Rona, by the way, we'll talk about in a minute, leading the county in just about every single offensive statistical category. Take a look again at your Madure Bonner Law defensive alignment here for Ellwood City, a local firm with deep ties in the community. Visit MadureBonnerLaw.com. Find out how they can serve you. Bisco, Cuevas, and Landis in the outfield from left to right. Widmeyer behind the dish. Aaron Lake, Isaiah Lutz on the left side of the infield. Keller and Nardone on the right side. Nate Kennedy will be on the hill here this afternoon. Leads the team now with 6 appearances, though only his second start of the season. 14 strikeouts and 4 walks, coming in with a 4.59 earned run average. But again, I like the whip number, about a 1.7 whip on the year for Nate Kennedy, the sophomore on the hill. So sophomores on the bump for both teams here today. Coach Nick Mariano, how about this one for Unique? He doesn't coach there. Coaches first. It's going to be Coach Mike Mallory. He's going to be down, trotting down to third base.
Even if you are not ready for the day, it cannot always be night.
And with that, ready to kick it off with the cousin combo at the top of the order. Robbie Fadden followed by Jay Rona. Lethal combination we saw all through football season and again through the basketball season as well. First pitch coming from Kennedy. It's going to be way outside. And your first pitch delivery brought to you by Penn, Ohio. Ball or water. Just learned something interesting, though. Talk about the four-sport athlete in Jay Rona. Baseball his best, obviously, with basketball. Played football and golf in the fall. 2-0 the count. Well, Cousin says, look, you can do it, I can do it as well. He's running track right now as well. Obviously, game day, so he's here rather than at the track meet at Laurel. Is Bobby Fadden. And this one he chops towards first, taking on a couple of hops there by Nardone, three unassisted for the first out of the inning. Apparently his first jump was an impressive number, over 18 feet on his first long jump at the first track meet of the year. Have a feeling we might be seeing him at the Tri-County Championships coming up in a couple of weeks as well. We'll have coverage of that next Saturday here at lcsportsnet.com. First pitch, backdoor breaking ball for strike one. And also interesting, both Fadden and Rona, they bat lefty, but throw righty. The 1-1, this one, or the 0-1, excuse me, hit towards short, long throw across, but in plenty of time for Lutz to retire Rona. Two up, two down. Now A.J. Verdi coming to the plate. Mentioned Cal U commit. Also a member of Extreme Leadership. Got to see him and Aaron Capalbo last week give a presentation on their project. One of the big ones, the having the athletes going down and hanging out with the elementary, their lunch buddies, as they called them. Breakfast buddies. This one misses upstairs for ball one. Yeah, I love kids who are doing things in and out of the classroom, creating projects to help the school and the community. 1-0 pitch misses way outside. 2-0 now the count to Verdi. Mentioned Rona leads the team and leads the county in most statistics. About the only thing he doesn't is ribbies. 10 RBIs on the year for Verdi to lead the team. This one misses outside as well. 3-0 the count here in the bottom of the first inning. He is going to take the whole way as Verdi, as Kennedy puts one over for called strike one. 3-1 now the count. Pizzullo awaiting in the on-deck circle. A nice breaking ball on 3-1, and the count runs full. Here to Verdi in the bottom of the first inning. Payoff pitch here from Kennedy. Another breaking ball. This one's fouled off and out of play. Count will remain 3-2. Yeah, big thanks to Coach Mariano, Coach Wise. Always good to us, getting us some fun information on the team. There's the payoff pitch again. Off the end of the bat, grounder towards third, or towards second, excuse me, to get the third out of the inning. A 1-2-3 inning in the bottom of the first on three groundouts. Played one complete. We're scoreless between Mohawk and Ellwood City. Back in a moment at lcsportsnet.com.
When it comes to shopping for insurance, there are thousands of options out there. MVP Insurance proactively shops and compares your policies to find the best coverage and rate. Josh Mathur and David Verratti want to provide you with the level of personalized service that you know that you are the MVP of their agency. They simplify insurance so you can live stress-free. Visit one of the locations in Xenoleopol or in New Springfield, Ohio. Call MVP for the win. Proud sponsor of the MVP of the game on the Lawrence County SportsNet.
Firefly Solar is a proud sponsor of LC SportsNet. From our regional business partnership to our community benefits agreement with local schools, Firefly Solar is dedicated to being an outstanding neighbor and beacon of economic support to the Lawrence County community. Let's create a stronger energy infrastructure while preserving the agricultural beauty of Lawrence County. Visit FireflySolarPA.com for more info about the Firefly Solar Project. Firefly Solar, creating a brighter future in Lawrence County.
Top of the second inning coming your way here in the Lawrence County SportsNet powered by LCAP. Scoreless here between Mohawk and Ellwood City. Some of the other games going on across the area, mentioned the ones in section, Quaker Valley hosting Shenango and Neshanic hosting Beaver Falls. Newcastle trailing Mars at last count 11-1, that game being played at Neshanic. Laurel trying to split the series against Seton LaSalle. Laurel, after starting the year on a hot streak, won the first four, but have now lost the last three in section play. And Wilmington at Reynolds. Softball schedule. Ellwood City is hosting Hopewell. That's a 5:30 first pitch in that one. I mentioned Mohawk is off. Newcastle hosting Western Beaver. Shenango hosting Riverside. Wilmington at Lakeview. Union hosting Carlinton. That game started at 4. It might be over at this point, to be honest. And the other game, the big one, a 5 o'clock start at Neshanic. Laurel against Neshanic. That game has been pushed back about 3-4 different times. We will have game 2 of that series, which is coming up on Friday. And that is the originally scheduled game. But as we mentioned, well, the weather not so great. So not entirely sure if we will see that. Will Nardone will lead off here in the inning. As we start here in the top of the second inning. First pitch swinging, that one's fouled out of play. We'll keep tabs on the pitch count throughout the course of this one as best as we can as well, as this one misses downstairs, evens the count at 1-1. That's where Game Changer has been a huge help. Good breaking ball there down at the knees for strike two. It's Nardone, Widmeyer, and Kennedy due up here in the inning. That was pitch number 20 in the game for Crawford. Breaking ball misses inside here. Count runs even at 2-2 here in the top of the second inning. This one, ground ball up the middle. Coming up and taking it, but Fadden's unable to handle it. It's going to be an E4, putting Nardone on base. First error of the game. And leadoff man on base for the second straight inning for Ellwood City. Now here comes Ryan Widmeyer. And wondered how small ball might play effect. See if they do again try to move over the runner, though Widmeyer, best hitter on the team so far this year with a .429 average coming into today's contest. Back in the box, but he is going to square, and a bunt is going to hit him in the box for strike one. Might have a moment. Let's take a look at our keys to the game. Timely hitting. It's what it's going to need to happen here. Mohawk got to keep throwing strikes. Ellwood City, a good job of doing what they can of moving runners, but you can't give them free runners on the walk. And like here on the error, throw behind the first base, but Chapman was charging to cover the bunt. So it's just a ball outside, 1-1 the count. Widmeyer again catching today, squares the bunt, gets this one down. It's going to be taken there by Verdi. Throw to first base in time. That's going to be a sacrifice. 2-4. That's one of the keys that Ellwood City needs. Didn't have his official key to the game. We'll talk about timely hitting, but part of that is getting the guys in the right spot. They got two runners in scoring position in the first inning. Couldn't capitalize. Widmeyer doing his job, moving it over. Now Nate Kennedy a chance to help himself with a runner in scoring position. So this is Kennedy at bat. And Crawford's going to step off. Trying to get the signals all situated. Breaking ball misses outside for ball one. Through eight batters, you got four first pitch strikes and four first pitch balls thrown by the sophomore right-hander. High kick and deliver, misses down and in, 2-0 the count. Throw behind to second base, is going to skip past Rona into the outfield, but Nardone's going to hang tight at second. Good backup by J.J. Nail out in center. Who know the count to Kennedy. Sam Landis, the nine hitter, awaiting in the on-deck circle. 2-0 inside corner. Kennedy had the lone RBI yesterday. Two, one off the end of the bat. Ground ball, rug burner to Fadden at second, thrown to first. So, familiar situation. Leadoff man gets on, sacrifice him over, and a ground out moves the runner to third. Runner on third with two down, nine hitter Sam Landis coming to the plate. Left-handed hitting right fielder, hitting 111 on the season. Crawford, first pitch, gets in the foul off, back and out of play. Thank you, sir. Nardone, who reached on an error, he stands at third. 1-0 pitch, misses outside, evens the count at 1-1. Two and one, that one's high and out of the zone. Remember, 100 pitches is the limit. Already 30 thrown by Crawford. This one, ground ball up the middle, a backhanded sliding effort. Fadden on a bounce to first, and it is in time. There's your Maley Chiropractic Play of the Game nomination right there. Beautiful effort coming all the way over and using the turf to his advantage with the bounce pass like it's basketball season. Still scoreless, heading to the bottom of the second. Back in a moment on the Lawrence County SportsNet.
Castle Asphalt and Construction is driven to provide quality, cost-efficient pavement-related services to Western Pennsylvania. Every paving or construction service at Castle Asphalt begins with a thorough site inspection of the area to allow their team of professionals to become familiar with the unique conditions of your home or business. Once the site inspection is complete, Castle Asphalt provides you with a detailed plan of the design, cost, materials, and time of completion so you know exactly what to expect during your construction. Visit castleasphalt.com to request a quote for your next project and make your dream design come to fruition.
Does your blueprint not match the vision of your building project? Not with Creative Edge Architecture. From concept to creation, Jeff Measel will help tackle the complex problems, creating design solutions and construction experience. Creative Edge gives you the edge design and construction meet.
For more than 120 years, people have been relying upon Martindale Hubbell's AV preeminent rating to select their attorneys. If you're involved in a workers' compensation situation, you should do the same. LGKG has been AV rated for over 40 years.
There's your Maley Chiropractic Play of the Game nomination that started. Getting out of the jam, it started with an error on Mohawk by Fadden, but he ends up making two outs, including the spectacular one, keeping it scoreless. As this one is popped up on the first pitch by Pazullo. Second baseman is going to settle under it and make the catch is Jordan Keller for the first out of the inning. So Nate Kennedy going four up, four down here to begin this one. And mentioned it for, again, taking a quick look at our keys to the game. Mohawk, they got to be the ones to manufacture. We saw Ellwood City try a couple times, but they've been unsuccessful. And Ellwood City, stop thief. Again, if you missed it during the pregame, we talked about it. They had 8 stolen bases yesterday, did Mohawk. One of the best ways to stop the thief is to, well, not let anybody on base. And so far, 4 up, 4 down for Kennedy and the Wolverines. And a first pitch strike here thrown to Bowser. Count not even at 1-1. It's Pizzullo, Bowser, and Chapman due up here in the inning. How about this? Bowser, one of 2 starters from yesterday who did not get a hit, but he did reach base via a walk in yesterday's contest. This breaking ball is lifted towards the right side as well. Landis fighting off the sun, but he's actually going to give way for Keller, the second baseman, backpedaling to make the catch. So again, 2 up, 2 down. Not sure what music Mr. Retort is selecting for us over here, but we'll go with it. Try to get you some score updates over the course of today's contest as well. Laurel Neshanic softball. First pitch just thrown in that one. 1-0 misses outside. 2-0 now the count to Jackson Chapman. RBI yesterday for the Warriors in the first game of this series. Back-to-back series. Gotta love the way that they have worked that here in the WPIAL. This one misses outside. 2-1 the count. This one downstairs, 3-1 the count as Widmeyer tried to bring it up into the zone. Got the this one off the end of the bat and foul back to the screen. Count now full with 1 down here in the bottom of the second inning. Ellwood City has stranded 3 runners in scoring position here in the contest. Mohawk looking for their first base runner of the game. Payoff pitch. Down right field, but that's going to go out of play. Count will remain full. Payoff pitch again. Ground ball, trying to slide at third base is Lake, but it goes under the glove. Upset with himself, he actually overran it. Tough play, that'll be a first base runner, and we'll give a single to Chapman. First hit of the game for the Mohawk Warriors. Now Mason Hopper comes to the plate, and he is the other player who yesterday did not get a hit, just him and Bowser. He'd love to flip that script right here. First pitch swinging foul back and out of play for strike 1. He had missed some time with the knee injury. Took basically a week and a half off. Kind of worked out nicely. I mean, if there's a good time to have an injury, it's when you have your bye week for section play. That one misses outside. Evens the count at 1-1. He's back at it. He asked during pregame as we were getting the camera set up, the strike zone cam, outside for a 2-1 count. He said, make sure you get my good side. Should have told him, lucky for him, he's playing left field, so he's not going to be seen on our strike zone cam out there. He's seen plenty here. Swing and a miss for strike 2. Tell you what, get a hit here and we'll definitely say it's your good side. That's Hopper now facing a 2-2 count with 2 down. Throw over to first, down in the pebbles. Good pick there by Nardone. That's Chapman able to scramble back in time. This one also lifted to the right side of the field. Again, Lane is fighting out the sun, and he finally does find it and settle under it to make the third out of the inning. So three groundouts in the first, three flyouts in the second. We've played two complete, still scoreless between Ellwood City and Mohawk. Back in a moment, it's the Lawrence County SportsNet, powered by LCAT.
Right now, someone very special needs your help. This is Jack Lynn, CEO of City Rescue Mission. No one is beyond God's love and care. One person's life can affect another. Though you may never meet this person, you can make a difference in his or her life. Hurting men and women in our community desperately need food, shelter, and physical and spiritual care. Some are struggling with abuse and addiction. They feel alone, unloved, and forgotten. Individual, caring people provide their hope. You can help change the lives of men, women, and children. Visit cityrescuemission.org and help us today.
Contractors, the Department of Healthy Homes needs you. From small to large residential projects, you can help families live safer and healthier with the quality work you do. It's rewarding in more ways than one. Call LCAP's Department of Healthy Homes today.
We head to the third inning. Ellwood City and Mohawk still scoreless. Again, Mohawk a perfect 5-0 record in section play, 7-1 overall. Ellwood City 3-5 overall, 1-5 so far in section play, and they're going to bring the top of the order due up here in the third inning, Bishop, Lutz, and Keller. Beautiful Bessemer, Pennsylvania, if you're Don Rebel and you're listening. Your line score there through the first two innings of play as we get ready for Crawford's first delivery of inning number three. Checking his swing there is Bishop, but not checking it fully. Called strike one. Oh, one foul tipped in the glove for strike two. Bishop, a 273 hitter on the year. Led off the game with a single. Now he's going to get his second hit of the game. Right back through the box. Good piece of hitting with two strikes. Bishop now 2-for-2. The issue is that he's got all the hits so far on the season. Long pause. He does square, but pulls back as this one misses downstairs for ball one. Crawford, 33 pitches coming into this inning. Kicks, fires, salutes, swinging at this one, but fouls it back and out of play. Count even at 1-1. Isaiah Lutz continuing his career, University of South Carolina, Lancaster. D1 JUCO baseball. Runner goes, throw down to second base, and Verdi is going to airmail into center field. So swipe bag for Bishop. And how about this? I mean, the keys we said were for Ellwood City to make sure Mohawk doesn't steal bases, and for Mohawk to manufacture. Well, guess what? It's complete opposite here so far in this game. Two swiped bags so far for Ellwood, and they're the ones doing the manufacturing. 2-1 the count as Crawford kicks and fires. This one's drilled towards right field. Keegan Hopper on his horse. He's going to watch it go over his head. That's going to plate the first run of the game. An RBI double by Isaiah Lutz, his second ribby of the season. Ellwood City, like yesterday, on the board first. Back-to-back hits. After Lutz and Biskup switch places, now Jordan Keller coming to the plate. He hit the ball hard in his first at bat as well. Ground ball out to Fadden at second. Still nobody down here in the top of the third inning. This breaking ball stays upstairs, evens the count at 1-1. Mind you, this is our Maley chiropractic inning. We'll have our this one's fouled down the first base line. And that's just gonna stay fair deep in right field. Good play by Keegan Hopper to make the catch, but it's deep enough that it's gonna allow Isaiah Lutz to tag up and head to third. First out of the inning, but a pseudo-sacrifice can't officially go down as a sacrifice. Now, insurance run. 90 feet away, trying to put a crooked number up on the board. Aaron Lake, a 238 hitter now at the plate, watches ball one upstairs. Crawford working from the windup. Misses upstairs here too, 2-0. Lake 2 RBI on the year. Unfortunately, both or everybody on this Ellwood City team, 2 is the most that any player has coming into today's contest. This one tails in but catches the inside corner for strike one. Yeah, Widmeyer, Lake, Kennedy, Landis, and Biskup, and also Roth with 2 RBI each. 2-1 pitch, hit the other way, and right on cue, Aaron Lake says, make that 3. Third ribby of the year, as he goes with the pitch and gets the Toshiba RBI. 2-0 in favor of Ellwood City. Toshiba RBI, call Dale at 412-290-2156 for all your printer output devices and digital workflow solutions, where you can visit business.toshiba.com. Click Find a Dealer near you. Boker now at the plate. That one misses inside for ball one. Second time Lake has been on base. Runner goes. This one's popped up, back foul and out of play. And aggressive as Lake was looking to get the third stolen base of the game. Would have been his second. Long pause this time from Crawford. He will throw over. Lake slides back in safely. Ellwood City, only 6 total stolen bases on the year coming into this game. 2 already through the first 3 innings. See if Lake is off and going again. He is not. This one misses up and in. A little chin music. Count now 2-1 to Gordon Boker. 1-for-6 on the year. Hasn't had a multitude of at-bats, but I think he likes when we're here. Had his first hit of the year in the game against Neshanic. Up on Eclipse Day. Runner does go. Ball low, throw down to second base, not in time. His second, team's third stolen base of the game. 2 balls, 2 strikes to count. But another runner in scoring position. Ellwood City needed a timely hitting. They've gotten a couple this inning. Can they get another? Ground ball, weakly hit towards third on a run. Pazullo has to throw it, and throw's going to be wide, and it gets away from the first baseman, Chapman. That's going to allow the run to score. We'll see how they rule that. I think it's probably got to be an infield single and then the error allowing the run to come around. I think you're going to give an infield hit on it. But definitely the errant throw leading to the run. That's one you'll probably see each school do it differently. Mohawk likely will call that an error. And Ellwood City likely will call it a hit, and it looks like we're going to have our first LGKG consultation, our trip to the mound. It's Coach Mariano trying to talk things over, make sure you get the best consultation. Free consultation when you go to lgkg.com. Are we going to get a pitching change? It looks like we are. So the 3-0 Ellwood City lead, we are going to have a red zone call to the bullpen. So we'll come back. We'll get you all those changes here in a moment. We'll be back. 3-0 Ellwood City on the Lawrence County SportsNet, powered by LCAT.
When the high school season heats up, make sure you have the best gear to support your school. Head to the Red Zone on Wilmington Road in the Shannock for all your county sporting apparel needs. From sporting goods to custom apparel to embroidery and more, the Red Zone has it all. Quality gear for all 8 schools in the County of Champions. Stop by and enter the Red Zone or visit them online at theredzonesports.com. Score big at the Red Zone.
All right, so back here, and it is still Briar Crawford who is throwing. Looked like they had somebody ready to come in for Mohawk, but it is not the case. So we do have, it looks like, a new first baseman. But didn't see if something happened on the errant throw, if Chapman may have gotten tripped up, did not see anything over there. As this one's lined back at the middle. Backhanded play by Fadden at second. On to Verona to first base for a 4-6-3 double play. The Cousin Connection, another Maley Chiropractic play nomination. Look at this one on your LCAP instant replay. Mohawk able to work out of the jam with a beautiful 4-6-3 twin killer. We'll head to the bottom of the third inning, but we're going to keep it right here as is tradition. It is time for the Maley Minute, and we're going to put me on the clock here for our Maley Minute as we take a look at the softball happenings across the county. Ellwood City, let's start with them. A huge win for the Wolverines yesterday, 6-4 over Central Valley. Their first loss of the year for the Warriors. Ellie Clance is a 3-run homer, and Requiston struck out 13 in the win, a 7-1 record for Ellwood City. As for Mohawk, they're also 7-1. They won 15-0 over Beaver Falls yesterday, a 3-inning no-hitter for Reagan Magno. How about this? 4 or 8 different Mohawk players hitting over 400. We'll have that Mohawk-Ellwood rematch on Monday. Mohawk plays Central Valley on Friday. Laurel and Neshanic, they're about to do battle. Laurel defeated Riverside yesterday 10-0. Neshanic 15-0 over New Brighton there yesterday as well. Laurel, by the way, the only team to beat Mohawk. Neshanic still undefeated. Shenango, Emma Herb, 3 runs and a 3 RBI performance in their win, 11-1 over Freedom yesterday. Kennedy Lynn, a 1-hitter with 12 strikeouts. Union, 18-0 and 15-0 in their doubleheader against Swickley yesterday. Mia Pruz and Corinne Shannon, each with no hitters. Newcastle got their first section win, 11-7 in the slugfest over Moon, a triple and 2 doubles for Olivia Hood, and she also got the win in the circle. And, of course, I can never get it in 60 seconds. It's the Maley Minute Plus. Wilmington, tough blow for both the baseball and softball teams yesterday. Wilmington, a 3-2 loss to West Middlesex in 10 innings yesterday. Maya Jewell both scored a run and drove in the other for the Hounds. That was their first loss of the year. I mentioned the baseball team. They lost as well in extra innings. That was I think it was 11-10 was the final in that one in 9 innings. There's your Maley Minute brought to you by Maley Chiropractic, keeping you in the game as we keep you in the game informed of what's going on across the County of Champions with the world of softball. Bottom of the third inning, 3 runs on the board. Mohawk's going to send to the plate, 8-9-1. Nail, Keegan Hopper, and then the top of the order in Fadden. But 3 runs on the board. I'm not sure if Ellwood City's gotten 3 runs in an inning all year long.
Like it's just you and me. I'm just saying how I feel, man. I ain't
First pitch to Nail. Catches the inside corner for strike one. That one tails away, evens the count at 1-1. Ground ball back up the middle, just past the diving effort of Isaiah Lutz. Good effort. J.J. Nail, though, gets the leadoff hit. Mohawk's lone loss came against Avonworth. That was a game where they gave up 9 runs in the top of the first inning. Other than that, not really a lot of adversity faced this year by the Warriors. Again, that Avonworth team, a pretty darn good one. We expect to see them making a deep run in the WPIAL playoffs. They made it to the semis last year. Keegan Hopper, first pitch misses outside, trying to go on maybe a little pitch out throw behind. Hustling back is Nail at first. This one fisted foul and out of play, evens the count at 1-1. 5 first pitch strikes, first 4 pitch balls the first time through the order. Squaring a bunt down the third baseline, a beauty. Hopper quickly down the line, a great play. No one covering third, trying to go first to third is Nail. He's not going to get back there in time. He's under the tag. And I think that's the right call. As he slid underneath the tag, Coach Wise is going to ask about it because Kennedy ended up covering, but I think that's a good call. I think Kennedy was able to slide around and under. Here's going to be a good look as you look at the LCAP instant replay. Tough to see because our camera, of course, just barely misses third base. But you can see the way he slides. I think he was under the tag. No, they're going to change it. He is out. And now you're going to see Coach Mariano have to ask why they're able to make that switch. A beautiful play, though. Now you have Ellwood City with a double play to potentially change for a play of the game. So sacrifice. 5-4. But in double play to 1. Coach Mariano.
No way you saw it from back there. No way.
So the question is, which umpire is the actual one who's supposed to be covering third on that? Which in a two-man system, believe yes, that is the home plate umpire because the first base umpire is the one who is having to cover the play at first, which means home plate then is the one at third, and home plate originally signaled safe.
No way you saw it from back there.
But if they're claiming that the base umpire ended up having the better angle at it, and with the way the slide was, that's tough to tell.
No way you saw it from back there. You had it right, home plate. You had it right. Back down.
Again, our replay sliding just out of the screen, unfortunately.
Even if you are not ready for the day, it cannot always be night.
So, tough break for Mohawk, but a big play for Ellwood City. Now two out, and Bobby Fadden coming to the plate. First pitch misses way outside. 4-1. How busy everybody is today. I'm sure our umpire faithful all on a field somewhere today as this one's drilled but way foul on the right field line. Count even at 1-1. See what the official verdict on that would be. One and one the count, now two down. Breaking ball outside. Count now 2-1. Ellwood City 3 runs in the top of the inning. Double play here in the bottom. Count now 3-1. Here to Fadden. Three-one from Kennedy. Ground ball right side. But right at the first baseman. Nardone. 3 unassisted to get Fadden out for the second time. And we're played 3 complete. No one left on base, so there was a hit and a double play. 3-0. Ellwood City leads Mohawk. We'll be back in a moment here on the Lawrence County SportsNet, powered by LCAP.
For 20 years, Maley Chiropractic has treated athletes of all ages to help them get safely back to the top of their game. Maley Chiropractic has 3 full-time doctors in their office, and all 3 are former area athletes who have had to battle injuries throughout their careers. They want to help you get safely back on your feet. But more importantly, help stop the injuries before they happen. Prehab before you rehab.
Attention all high school student athletes. During your sports season, a $30 visit to the Maley Chiropractic office includes an adjustment and or all therapy is necessary.
From the athletes of tomorrow to the weekend warriors and everything in between. Let Maley Chiropractic keep you in the game.
In workers' compensation, my clients are oftentimes not receiving their wage loss. They're not receiving their medical expenses. LGKG, they come to us so that we can put them in a position to pay their bills. If we're keeping our promises, our clients are getting the justice they deserve.
Top of the fourth inning coming your way, and we do have a pitching change coming your way as well. As they're now going to have Jackson Chapman move to the mound. He'll move from first base to the mound. Briar Crawford's day is done after 3 innings of work. Aiden Bowser is going to first base. So, Professor Briggs, if you're listening, yes, Mohawk has lost the DH. Get you some numbers here on new pitcher Jackson Chapman. He pitched yesterday. Pitched an inning in relief, as did Bobby Fadden, the second baseman. Chapman on the year, his 5th appearance, they've all been out of the bullpen. 7 2/3 innings, allowed just 1 run, 10 strikeouts, and 1 walk on the year. First pitch, breaking ball, catches the outside corner for strike one to Ryan Widmeyer. It's 7-8-9, the batters due up here in the inning. This one's popped up towards shallow center field. J.J. Nail is going to settle under it and make the catch for the first out of the inning. So pitcher of record right now for Mohawk is the starter, Briar Crawford. 3 innings pitched. Gave up 3 runs, of which 2 were earned. 1 walk, no strikeouts. First pitch chopped foul by Nate Kennedy. 0-1 to count. So mentioned that he did pitch yesterday, did Jackson Chapman. Gave up 1 hit and struck out a batter in his 1 inning of work. But he only threw 13 pitches, so he is under that 25-pitch limit. That's why he is able to pitch without any days of rest. One, 0-2 pitch, chop towards short. Getting on the run is Rona, and plenty of time to retire Kennedy for the second out of the inning. 2 up, 2 down, and Sam Landis now coming to the plate. Coming up after the game, we will announce our MVP insurance MVP of the game. First pitch misses upstairs for ball one. One-oh breaking ball catches the outside corner on the back door. Evens the count at 1-1. Point of note, Jackson Chapman, his windup position would have been illegal over the last couple of years with that hybrid position. Need to have both feet essentially at the pitcher's plate would be extended forever. Both feet have to be either in contact with the plate or would be in contact if it extended forever. They got rid of that hybrid rule a couple years ago because basically, well, it was never enforced properly and not even considered a rule in college and professional balls. This one's a foul ball and caught against the fence. Down the third base line. Beautiful catch, Vinny Pizzullo finding the fence and making the catch to end the inning. Mohawk, though, trails 3-0. See if they can wake up the bats. We'll be back in a moment. Good battle here on Lawrence County SportsNet, powered by LCAP.
At Mador Bonner Law, we're more than just attorneys. We're your community partners. With a combined experience that spans decades, attorneys Jason Mador, Michael Bonner, and Greg Rossitelli are your trusted advisors for all legal matters. From personal injury to estate planning, business law to family disputes, we are here to guide you through every step of the legal process. Our full-service, community-based approach ensures that you're not just a client, but a valued member of our family. Give us a call or visit us online at madorbonnerlaw.com for more information.
In workers' compensation, my clients are oftentimes not receiving their wage loss. They're not receiving their medical expenses. LGKG, they come to us so that we can put them in a position to pay their bills. If we're keeping our promises, our clients are getting the justice they deserve.
Looking for quality concrete services? Contact the experienced professionals at Doran Concrete. Our company is family, locally owned and operated, and has been serving the community for over 30 years. Get residential or commercial concrete services for any size job. Our skilled professionals offer prompt and reliable services at an affordable price. We believe in the principles of honesty, integrity, and reliability. Get in touch with us for exceptional concrete services at prices that you can afford.
Heading now to the bottom of the fourth inning, Mohawk trailing by a 3-0 scoreline, something that they have not faced much this year. They send 2-3-4 hitters up in Rona, Verdi, and Pizzullo. Jay Rona coming into today's game, leading the county with a .636 batting average. Trying to get things kick-started is the YSU commit, but he hits one into the ground, taken by Keller at second base, 4-3 put out. For a big first out of the inning. Top of the order has, so far they've been beating the ball into the ground. A.J. Verdi also a ground out to second base in his first at bat. As Kennedy has done a great job mixing his pitches so far. Soon as I say that, Verdi gives this one a ride. Cuevas giving chase deep to the wall. It's going to bounce and two-hop the wall, and extra bases for A.J. Verdi, a one-out double, his third of the year. Mohawk officially gets their first player in scoring position, and now we're going to have our Castle Asphalt courtesy runner. Heading out to run for him, the courtesy for the catcher is Cash Stratton. There's your Castle Asphalt courtesy runner. Cash Stratton, who had a couple of stolen bases in yesterday's game as the courtesy runner, now runs at second. Vinny Pizzullo coming to the plate, third straight inning with a hit for the Warriors. Yet to capitalize so far as this pitch misses outside for ball one. Kennedy winds, fires, swing and a miss. Good pitch from Kennedy. Looks like he got Pizzullo out in front. Evens the count at 1-1. Pizzullo, a .360 hitter on the year and has the team's only triple on the season. The wind picking up here a bit at Mohawk High School. This one's popped down the right field line, giving chase over there is Nardone, but he's going to run out of real estate. And it'll go out of play. About this, we've played 3.5 innings, neither team with a strikeout. I mean, it is game two of the series, so in theory you're likely having your number two pitchers on the hill to start both games. But still, it's kind of impressive. These hitters have done a great job of putting balls in play throughout the course of this game as Pizzullo requests time and is granted. Pizzullo, the only player yesterday with a multi-hit game. He went 2-for-4 in game one down there at Sanders Field. Here's the 1-2. Breaking ball fouled right back to the screen. Count will remain 1-2. Give a shout out Brad Winhurst running the Ellwood game changer from the dugout. Big win for the Shenango softball team. They just defeated Riverside 3-1. Huge win for the Cats. This one's drilled to deep left field. That one's off the wall. Pizzullo will trade places with Stratton, the courtesy runner, and get the Toshiba RBI. Monster blast as this one landed just under the yellow covering at the top of the fence. Back-to-back doubles for the Warriors. Verdi's hung up a little bit in the air, but no doubt about that one off the bat. You knew that was extra bases and potential to get out of here. Just barely missed. First pitch swinging this time here is Aiden Bowser, the DH now the pitcher. He flies it to right. That's going to be deep enough that Pizzullo's going to attempt the tag and will do so successfully off to third. So now two down, Pizzullo in scoring position. And that RBI brought to you by Toshiba. Visit them online, business.toshiba.com. Click find a dealer near you or give Dale a call, 412-290-2156. And Coach Wise heading out there. That's three straight balls that have been hit pretty well by Mohawk batters. So maybe just a chance to calm down the pitcher, your LGKG trip to the mound. Consultation time there for Ellwood City. You can visit LGKG online. Let their law firm of AV-rated attorneys and super lawyers guide you through the legal process. LGKG.com. Runner on third with two down. Going from the windup will be Lake for Chapman. Now the pitcher for Mohawk. Watching the first pitch breaking ball and a beauty for strike one. Pizzullo, the RBI double. That was his 10th of the year. Tied now for the team lead. He stands at third. Good breaking ball there. Swung on and missed by Chapman. Count now 0-2. Way ahead. We'll see what Kennedy, the sophomore, chooses to do. 0-2 pitch. Breaking ball lifted down the right field line, giving chase Arlandis and Nardone, and they're going to run out of real estate. Now one's going to plug, and that's the one real danger spot on this field right now. Right field is the wet spot. They said that they pumped out 500 gallons of water down the right field line before their game against Neshanic. That was the game that was moved up by 24 hours over Easter weekend. That right field is the spot that needs the most work. They're plan is, well, the plan was to get new fencing to laser level the field before the season happened, just, you know, time constraints, order of operations and all that. We're unable to get all that done. Another one popped foul out of play. But that's the plan when this season ends, is to laser level, try to take care of some of those low spots, especially in right field, that have caused those swampy areas. That was a long run, too, for Keller and Landis and company. Chop down the third baseline. Error against Coach Malley. Three straight fouled off, though, by Jackson Chapman. Count will remain 0-2. K Kennedy again, the 0-2. This one's hit back through the middle. It's going to be a soft liner, and it's going to be a two-out RBI single on the 0-2 pitch. Good piece of hitting for Chapman to get his third RBI of the season. So Mohawk not going anywhere anytime soon. RBI double from Pizzullo, and he scores on the Chapman single. And it looks like we're going to have a substitution. Or no, I'm sorry, that is not the pitcher who Chapman is the pitcher. So that's another Castle Asphalt courtesy runner. They provide commercial or residential asphalt paving and line striping as the freshman Drew Rona will run at first base. He with two down. First pitch misses outside for ball one. Mason Hopper at the plate. So we saw Stratton and Drew Rona now as courtesy runners. One for the pitcher, one for the catcher. Good block by Widmeyer behind the dish. We'll keep Rona there at first. The 2-0. Two and one to count to Mason Hopper. Long pause. Kennedy's going to step off and throw over. Rona back easily. Largest roster that we've seen from a Mohawk team in many, many years. I think they only had officially 14 on the varsity roster last year when they're going through the playoff run. Another throw over, this time sliding safely, is Drew. Already 24 pitches thrown this inning from the sophomore Nate Kennedy. 25 is a beauty, catches the outside corner for strike two. Count now even at 2-2 for Hopper, a 272 hitter coming into today's contest. Two balls, two strikes, two down. Kennedy delivers. Lifted towards left field, maybe just got under it. Bishop settling under it. Now takes a couple steps in and makes the catch to end the inning. But damage done. Mohawk gets a pair of runs back, two runs on three hits. And they strand a runner on the bags. 3-2 after four innings of play. We got a good one here at Mohawk High School. Don't go anywhere. It's the Lawrence County SportsNet, powered by LCAP.
Works in Progress Painting wishes a successful and satisfying season to all the Lawrence County sports teams and athletes. Work hard and bring honor to your team, school, and family in how you play. Joe Wright and his family have been providing painting, window cleaning, and other property services for business and homeowners in the Lawrence County area for over 10 years. Their goal on every project is to provide a meaningful service that honors their customer, God, and their family, and to have fun while doing it. Works in Progress is now booking interior painting projects for both residential and commercial projects. Call Joe today at 724-714-4294 to discuss your next project.
Congratulations to our March LCAP Team of the Month. The Lawrence County Sports Center is proud to honor Neshanic Hockey as the March LCAP Team of the Month after winning their third PIHL championship in the last 4 years. Congratulations to Coach Mark Volteri and the Neshanic Hockey Team, your March LCAP Team of the Month. Lawrence County Sports Center is proud to honor Giovanni Valentine of Neshanic Hockey as the March LGKG Male Athlete of the Month after leading the Lancers to a PIHL championship. LC Sports Center is also proud to honor Alexis Brewer of Laurel Wrestling as the March LGKG Red Zone Female Athlete of the Month for her journey through the consolation bracket to a PIAA 7th place finish. Congratulations and best of luck to Neshanic's Gio Valentine and Laurel's Alexis Brewer, the LGKG Athletes of the Month.
Top of the fifth inning coming your way. Ellwood City 3 runs in the third. Mohawk 2 runs in the fourth. 3-2 your score. The visiting Wolverines with the lead. Jackson Chapman in his second inning of relief. He will face the top of the order, Bishop, Lutz, and Keller. Jacob Bishop has had himself a day so far in the leadoff hole today. Now has a 2-0 count. He's been on base with a pair of singles already. Potential MVP Insurance MVP of the game, where they coach clients to better prices, better coverage. Call MVP for the win. Visit MVPINS.com. That one catches the top of the zone for strike one. The 2-1 from Chapman. Plunks him. So third time on base now for Jacob Biskup. And 4 out of 5 innings in the ball game, a leadoff batter has gotten on for Ellwood City. Didn't go so well in the first two, but a 3-run third inning. That's the difference in this one. Ellwood City trying to earn the split. Lutz sacked once, attempted the sacrifice, and then got a double in his second at bat. An RBI double, his second of the year. Watches the first pitch for strike one. Warming up down the right field line, or excuse me, the left field line for Ellwood City. In the bullpen is Aaron Lake. So we'll see, might be the end of the line for starting pitcher Nate Kennedy. 30 pitches that last inning for Kennedy. Chapman on in relief, scoring the bunt, but pulling back as that one misses well upstairs. Count even at 1-1. Long pause from Chapman and time granted in the box to Isaiah Lutz. Jimmy Hart, good job getting out of the way before any pitch could potentially be delivered. Scoring again, the bunt, and this time chasing one up out of the zone was Lutz. It'll be strike two. Biskup sliding back in safely on the back pick attempt from Verdi. Not sure if you noticed, both teams using the wrist coach, getting the calls in from the bases with the number combination. Another throw over, back safely, is Biskup. The 1-2 from Chapman, breaking ball, lifted towards left field. Mason Hopper backpedaling, now settles under it and makes a catch for the first out of the inning. Get you another out-of-town scoreboard update from the Newcastle Transit Authority. Newcastle softball loses to Western Beaver. Rough one there, 13-0 while we're on Newcastle. Newcastle baseball played the first game at Neshanic today. Mars all over them, 15-2 as the Planets get the sweep of the Canes. Try to get you some other scores here over the course of this afternoon as this first pitch misses outside for ball one to Jordan Keller. 0-2 on the day for Keller. Wilmington leading Reynolds 7-1. Weak ground ball towards second base. Fadden, his only play is going to be to first. And good stretch at first there by Bowser to ensure the out. Biskup advances to second on the play. So after the leadoff hit batsman, a couple of outs. But a runner now in scoring position for Aaron Lake. Third baseman, he's been on base twice today. Walked in the first, singled and scored in that three-run third inning. And this one hits in. So Biskup and Lake on the bags, and they've both reached base all three times they've come to the plate. Union defeated Carlinton 15-0 in softball action. Big score update will bring you after this pitch from the section. Nice breaking ball there for strike one to Gordon Boker. Quaker Valley leading Shenango, trying to get the sweep. There are the Quakers at home. Bottom of the fourth inning, they're leading 11-5. High-scoring affair there between the Cats and the Quakers. Strike two on that breaking ball. Neshanic softball leading Laurel 2-0 early in that one. Here a 3-2 game, 0-2 count. Chapman delivers to Boker. Runners off and running. Breaking ball, a swing and a miss. Good afternoon, good evening, and good night. How about that? That is your first strikeout of the game for either team. But it leaves a pair of Wolverine runners on the bags as a result. To the bottom of the fifth inning we go. Ellwood leading Mohawk 3-2 on the Lawrence County SportsNet, powered by LCAP.
Whew. For more than 120 years, people have relied on Martindale Hubbell's preeminent rating to select their attorneys. If you've been involved in an automobile accident, you should do the same. At LGKG, we have been preeminently rated for over 40 years.
No two companies create the same way. Toshiba empowers the art of business by uniquely enabling businesses to work with tools designed specifically for them. In a constantly evolving world, business communication must be agile, efficient, and fast. Toshiba is the company that helps you manage it all, from paper to digital to screen and back again. Toshiba, empowering the art of business.
To the bottom of the fifth inning we go. Mohawk with two in the bottom of the fourth. Now a chance to potentially tie or maybe even take the lead, but we'll have a red zone pitching change coming up here first, as it's going to be Aaron Lake now heading to the mound here for Ellwood City. Make sure you stop by the red zone on Wilmington Road in Neshanic Township. For all of your county sporting apparel needs, a member of Spirit Sales can help raise big money for your organization. Just fill out a form. The red zone does the rest. See how your group can score big at the red zone. So we'll get the full changes here, but Aaron Lake is going to go to the mound. So Kennedy, four innings pitched, gave up five hits, two runs, they were both earned. See where Kennedy ended up going. I think it's probably going to be a straight switch, him going to third and Lake going to the mound. That is exactly what it is. So Kennedy will move to third. Aaron Lake. Kennedy to third and Lake to the mound. No walks, no strikeouts, but is currently the pitcher of record is Nate Kennedy. Swings it over to big Aaron Lake. First pitch in there for strike one. So from one sophomore to another, how about the sophomore pitchers? This one misses way up and in. To J.J. Nail, singled in his first at-bat. Nail, Keeganhopper, and Fadden do up for the Warriors. One and one to count. As Lake fires, breaking ball wraps around the plate. Two and one to count. And this one down to the pebbles, 3-1 now to Nail. The eighth batter in the order, the leadoff batter here today. 3-1 count here to Nail. Catches the top of the zone, count will run full to Nail. Lake, 5 2/3 innings pitched on the year, 9 strikeouts and 5 walks. This is his fourth appearance, and they've all come out of the pen. Payoff pitch froze him, and there's the Ellwood City first strikeout of the game. And that brings Keegan Hopper with the great walk-up music coming to the plate. Hopper sacrificed, but ended up being part of a double play in the first inning. He's swinging here, and he's got a hot bat still coming. Came into this game hitting 400. That's the way you want to see the batter in the nine hole do his job, get on base. He represents the tying run. He turns it over. A couple of ground outs for Bobby Fadden so far on the day.
Even if you are not ready for the day, it cannot always be night.
First pitch swinging is Fadden, taking a one hop at short by Lutz, and it's going to be tough to get the speedy Fadden on the double play. It'll be a fielder's choice, 6-4, to retire the lead runner. Tell you what, good play there by Isaiah Lutz, because that ball had a lot of English on it. So now with two down, J. Michael Rona coming to the plate. Mentioned leading the county with a .636 batting average. How about this? On base percentage, 700 plus, 733 to be exact. Reached base three times yesterday, looking to get on for the first time here today. Breaking ball down in the pebbles, downstairs for ball one. Speedy Bobby Fadden on first. You wonder if they might try to manufacture that run. One of the keys to the game brought to you by Works in Progress. They try to get him in fielder's position. This one chopped towards third base. Tough play there by Kennedy. Long throw across the diamond and picked by Will Nardone. Ground out ends the inning and ends the threat. No runs, one hit. That runner left stranded on the bags. We've played five complete. Ellwood City leading 3-2 on LCSportsNet.com, powered by LCAP.
Tired of gasoline costs? Why drive? Let the Newcastle Transit Authority take you where you want to go. Serving the city of Newcastle and stops throughout Lawrence County, as well as weekday service to Pittsburgh, public transportation just makes sense. Why drive when you can relax and ride? For more information or for route schedules, log on to newcastletransit.org. The Newcastle Transit Authority, going your way. And remember, senior citizens ride free.
Firefly Solar is a proud sponsor of LC Sportsnet. From our regional business partnership to our community benefits agreement with local schools, Firefly Solar is dedicated to being an outstanding neighbor and beacon of economic support to the Lawrence County community. Let's create a stronger energy infrastructure while preserving the agricultural beauty of Lawrence County. Visit FireflySolarPA.com for more info about the Firefly Solar Project. Firefly Solar, creating a brighter future in Lawrence County.
Been a beautiful day here at Mohawk, been a beautiful game between the Wolverines and the Warriors, and right now a 3-2 Ellwood City lead as we head to the top of the sixth inning. Nardone, Widmeyer, and Kennedy, the 6-7-8 hitters due up for Ellwood City, as Caden Butch again giving us the music between innings. Need to see if we can start getting requests there from Caden Butch. Will Nardone. First pitch misses upstairs for ball one to him. Nardone, who was the starting pitcher yesterday for Ellwood City, 5 2/3 innings, gave up five runs. They were all earned. Pair of strikeouts in that game. It's up with a 2-0 count. Takes the 2-0 pitch, and it's popped towards center field. Nail does settle under it, and he'll make the catch out in center for the first out of the inning. Nardone now 0-3, an error, reached on an error, a double play, and that flyout. Ryan Widmeyer now to the plate, top batting average on the team coming into today's game. 0-3 yesterday, now behind the dish here today for Ellwood City. He's first pitch swinging. It's going to be fouled back. Good play by Kennedy the on deck batter. This ball is lifted towards left field. Hopper drifting towards the line is going to make the catch on the run. Just in fair territory for the second out of the inning. So two up, two down. Here in the top of the sixth, Nate Kennedy 0 for 2 with a pair of ground outs will now come to the plate. 2-0 the score in the Neshanic Laurel game. We'll have coverage of that second matchup. That one coming on Friday. Though Jimmy DiNardo is going to say, may not end up happening. Third hit batsman of the game, though. Third time that Chapman has put a runner on the hard way. Kennedy on base with two down. Now Sam Landis will come to the plate. He's 0 for 2 on the day. And we talked about it earlier. I don't think we ever completed the story. So Joseph Roth missed about 2 weeks. He pulled a hamstring. Think about all the work that Joseph Roth did on the basketball court. He pulled his hamstring on a walk, jogging down to first base. And then the just terrible field conditions that you had in some of the games early to start the year. It's kind of slipped on the grass going down to first base and pulled a hamstring. Tried to play yesterday, played for the first few innings, did get a hit, but couldn't do it. He's back on the DL, unfortunately. 0-1 the count now to Landis. And he rips this one, and it's going to be over the head of Fadden into right field for a hit. Trying to go first to third will be Kennedy, and he'll do so standing up. Sam Landis, beautiful swing, inside-out swing. Runners on the corners now with two down. Maybe a little two-out lightning for the Wolverines. And don't look now, but you got Jacob Biskup, who's been on base three times today. The leadoff man coming to the plate. Biskup came in today with a .273 batting average. Watch the first pitch miss outside. 4-1. Runners on the corners. Chap checks, delivers. Another breaking ball, and somehow it missed. Biskup, I have no idea how it did miss him. Everyone up here in the booth kind of looking at each other of... asking if Biskup is ethereal, maybe. 2-0 pitch, catch at the top of the zone. Count now 2-1. Biskup 407 on base percentage coming into today's game. That's just going up. Now the 2-1. Ground ball, third base, passed. The third baseman trying to slide and get it there was Pozzullo, unable to do so. How about that? Two outs, you get a hit batsman, a single, and then for the fourth time on base today, Jacob Biskup gets the single. He's 3 for 3 now with an RBI, and that's a huge insurance run right there for the Wolverines, and it all came here with two outs. Lutz 1 for 2. First pitch, breaking ball misses outside for 1. That's why you never give up, and every coach you talk to here talks about how important it is. Time was granted well before the pitch there from Chapman. But how important it is to get runners in when you can, because you just, no lead is ever going to be safe. Kind of a half swing there from Lutz. He's going to be fouled down the right field line and out of play. I was going to say, they already used the offensive conference here in the inning. cannot use your only one per inning. Breaking ball down at the knees for strike two. One ball, two strike. Landis at second. Biscup at first, and that one fouled back and out of play. Two up for Mohawk is the 3-4-5 hitters. Ferdi, Pizzullo, and Bowser. First need to get one more out to get out of the top of the six, and they will with the strikeout. Ferdi will throw down the first 2-3 to complete the K. Second strikeout for Chapman, but damage done, all with two outs. A run with a pair of hits and a hit batsman, but two runners left on the bags. To the bottom of the sixth inning we go. Back in a moment on the Lawrence County SportsNet, powered by LCAP.
Don't get left out to dry. Call the Penn, Ohio Bottled Water Company for the fastest and most efficient bottled water delivery service in the area. Penn, Ohio offers bottled water ranging from 16.9-ounce bottles to 5-gallon jugs, perfect for your next event or office water cooler system. Also, don't forget to ask about their custom labeling options. Visit PennOhioBottledWater.com for more information and to get a quote on their delivery services. Whether it's at home, in the office, or on the sidelines, Penn, Ohio has you covered.
I think the key to any attorney-client relationship is trust. My father told me a long time ago, the definition of personal integrity, it's really simple. Do what you say you're going to do. At LGKG, we've been doing that for over 80 years.
GEM Building Contractors and Developers have a proven record of performance on any size project. They bring value, local craftsmanship, expert management to meet any challenge. From design construction, from inspection to budget estimation, GEM Builder has been building our community for 70 years.
Now, how big could that insurance run end up being? Ellwood City now leading 4-2. Yes, two at-bats remaining for Mohawk, but they do send the 3-4-5 hitters in Verdi, Pizzullo, and Bowser here to the plate. Final score just came in, Seton LaSalle 7, Laurel 2, so Seton LaSalle completes the sweep there over the Spartans. Verdi, a double in his last at bat, watches a beautiful first pitch breaking ball from Aaron Lake, working his second inning of relief. Another breaking ball, this one misses downstairs, evens the count at 1-1. Verdi, a 320 hitter, had a pair of ribbies yesterday and scored the first run of today's game. Well, technically his courtesy runner did. Here's the 1-1. Ground ball down the third baseline. Goes foul. That's the one issue I have had with the way stats end up working, is that the courtesy runner, in my mind, should get credit for, you know, stolen bases, that sort of thing. But the run itself, in my mind, should go to the actual player credited in the game, which a courtesy runner is not officially in the batting order. So Verdi, when you look at the stats, it's listed as having 0 runs scored. Ah, the catcher just got hit on the arm. And there it is, right on cue. Your courtesy runner, again brought to you by Castle Asphalt, will come back out. Will be Cash Stratton. Castle Asphalt and Construction, they know the importance of making a good first impression, and no matter how elegant your home or office may be, if you match it with poor road surfaces, well, your friends or potential clients could regret making the trip. Oh, actually, it's going to be Talon Swanson this time going out there as a courtesy runner. So a new courtesy runner from Mohawk. Interesting. So Vinny Pizzullo will go to the plate. Pizzullo, the RBI double his last at bat. Had to wait for the umpires to get everything situated. Now we're ready to play. Throw over to try to pick off Swanson, the sophomore back in there fine. Pizzullo had his fourth double of the season, team high. Put it off the wall in left center field. First pitch swinging here, and this one's popped up down the right field line, giving chase again, and a diving effort, but not quite able to get to it. was Jordan Keller. Tell you what, kid who's played catcher basically all year and most of last year, working hard, playing in the mud out there at second base, and I think going to allow Coach Wise to go and check on him and make sure that he is okay, because, well, his uniform is more brown than it is blue and white now. But again, that's the normal catcher sprinting out down the right field line and making sure that his player is now okay. He's a catcher now playing second base today. Because what was the stat? 8 stolen bases yesterday for Mohawk. They switched the catcher up today. Don't even believe they've attempted one here today. Has Mohawk. Though it's Ellwood with the 3 swiped bags instead. 0-1 pitch, another one popped up. This one, though, in play. And this time it'll be going off is Keller, as Landis calls him off to make the catch for the first out of the inning, one down. Aiden Bowser, a couple of flyouts in his 2 at-bats today. Looking for his first hit of the series, a .222 hitter on the season. First pitch misses downstairs for ball one to Bowser. Four-two-year score, bottom of the 6th inning. Right down Broadway, evens the count at 1-1. Again, Mohawk, a 5-0 section record, currently on top of the standings in section 1. Riverside a half game back. Ellwood City, again, don't want to call it a must win, but this is huge. Coming in with a 1-5 section record. Ball got away. Actually, it was blocked first by Widmeyer, and then he kind of kicked it away from himself. But able to track it down quickly enough, and runner at first base and Swanson unable to go anywhere. Didn't get a chance to mention it either, though. The Trib Live rankings, Class 3A, Riverside, defending state champions, no shock, they're top of those standings, top of those rankings. Mohawk right now ranked 4th in Class 3A. As this one's fisted towards shallow right center field, that's going to fall in for a base hit. Trying to go first to third and doing so easily is Swanson, as Cuevas, tough time handling it on the bounce out there and right. The flare to right for Bowser, his first hit of the series, runners on the corners. Now coming to the plate is the pitcher, Jackson Chapman. Scatman. 2 for 2 on the day, including an RBI single back in the 4th. Tying run on the base paths, though, now for Mohawk with one down. And I think we're going to get a pinch runner now. And we are. So Drew Rona, who we saw originally as a courtesy runner, is now going to go in as a pinch runner for Bowser. So now he is officially in the game, unlike a courtesy runner. The issue is now he can't go back as the courtesy runner. He ran for the pitcher Chapman earlier in the game. So now he's on base for Chapman batting. Runners on the corners. Swanson, the courtesy runner at third. Rona, pinch runner, sliding back in at first. First pitch misses down and away, 4-1. It's been a very consistent zone all throughout the day. The 1-0. This one does catch the outside corner, evens the count at 1-1. Yeah, some might say maybe a bit of a tighter zone from where we sit, right behind home plate, a little bit elevated. Everything's looked pretty consistently good. You've got the great view from the strike zone, Cam. Watching at home. Throwback. Rona able to get back. That's Drew Rona at first. Talon Swanson standing at third. His run means not much right now. Chap flares this one to right field. Landis is going to settle under it, make the catch. Swanson had to retreat back to third, and now he's not going to be able to tag up. The ball was hit so quickly, Swanson couldn't get back in time. He may have thought that it was going to be landing in. Nonetheless, what could have been a sack fly just goes at an F9, and still runners on the corners. A rare base-running blunder from the Warriors. I didn't see it. I was watching the play. Not sure if Swanson slipped up or if he was leaning the wrong direction. But ended up getting held up. And now Mason Hopper, 0 for 2, comes to the plate. Breaking ball stays upstairs for ball one. And now you got a 1 or 2. What will Mohawk potentially do? Runners on the corners. Do you try to manufacture a run with a double steal type scenario? Rona not going from first base yet. Count even at 1-1. Coach Malley at third gives the call out, looking at the wrist coach. Here's the 1-1, runner does go. Check swing, here's a throw down to second. It's gonna be in a center field, it deflected off the glove of the second baseman, Keller. And on the errant throw, that's going to be a run scored for Mohawk. So you credit Drew Rona with the swiped bag. It was, yep, it'd be 2-1. And that's the first error of the game. Not sure. I think they're going to try to check on the last. Was there a swing on the last play? He's trying to say, hey, was the last pitch, did he swing or not? I mean, it's tough no matter what. The base umpire is behind second base. I'm not sure he's going to see much better than. One run on board. Back to a one-run game, and that's the tying run now in scoring position. Swung on, foul tipped in the glove. Count now 2-2 to Mason Hopper. Drew Rona, the pinch runner, standing at second. Two balls, two strikes, two down. 2-2, called strike three. Painted the corner on the outside. Mohawk able to get the run back. One run, one hit, one error, and a runner left on the bags. We've played six complete. Mohawk still trailing Ellwood City 4-3. Seventh inning, when we return, it's LCSportsNet.com, powered by LCAP.
I love what I do because coming in every day is different.
How can you not enjoy these kids coming up and hugging you and giving you these great smiles all throughout the day?
Seeing the progress that our kids make every single day is one of the reasons I love coming to school.
What should we do?
We have fun.
LCAP Early Learning Centers is hiring. Help empower young minds in Lawrence County and become a superhero today. Apply at LCAP.org.
I'm Kevin Schaff. I'm president of the Mohawk Education Association. We are one of the sponsors for the Lawrence County SportsNet. We would like to take a moment to wish all of Lawrence County student athletes health and safety as they compete. In particular, we would like to wish luck to all of Mohawk student athletes as they represent our school with pride.
To the seventh inning, we go with a 4-3 lead. Ellwood City leading Mohawk. They got an insurance run in the top of the sixth at Ellwood City. Mohawk able to get it right back. And now Ellwood City sending to the plate their 3-4-5 hitters to try to get one more insurance run before it's last chance time for the Warriors. Good first pitch breaking ball to Keller for strike one. Here's a score update coming from Shenango after this pitch. Beautiful breaking ball there. Misses downstairs, even the count at 1-1. Mentioned Quaker Valley led Shenango 11-5 earlier in the game. Shenango now leads 14-12. As this one's lifted towards right field, drifting towards the line is Keegan Hopper. He'll make the catch for the first out of the inning. That game is just in the fifth, that Shenango against Quaker Valley game. Those teams have combined for 26 runs and 23 hits and 9 errors. Yikes. Quaker Valley actually led 7-0 at the end of the first inning, but they now trail that one by a 14-12 score, Shenango leading Quaker Valley. First pitch breaking ball misses high and inside to Aaron Lake for ball one. He's also been on base 3 times today. He and Biscup, potential nominations for a MVP insurance. MVP of the game. Coming up after the game, we'll have our Creative Edge scoring recap, where design and construction come together with experience. Good 2-0 breaking ball there as Lake swings and misses. Starting third baseman Lake now on in relief. He'll face 8-9-1 Mohawk hitters in the bottom of the seventh. Another breaking ball, foul back and out of play. 2-2. Now the count. Probably have a moment. Have our LGKG Athletes of the Month. Gio Valentine and the Shannock and Alexis Brua of Laurel. 2-2 pitch. High fastball lifted again towards right field. Hopper able to fight off the sun and make the catch for the second out of the inning. Both flyouts to Keegan Hopper out in right. Keegan, one of 6 seniors in the starting lineup. 8 seniors, all part of the ribbon cutting ceremony they had a week ago against Wilmington. First pitch inside, and that's now 4. Breaking ball goes inside, and Boker got the worst of that one as that one hit off the helmet. I think Coach Wise is going to have a word just because that is 4 batters that have been plunked. I mean, there's nothing intentional whatsoever. It's a first pitch breaking ball that misses inside, but it is worth mentioning. Yes, so that is the fourth pitcher or the fourth batter that Chapman has hit. Good to see Boker's going to stay in there, run for himself. And we're going to have a substitution. I think what I just heard Coach Wise say is that the DH is going to come out of the game, that you're going to see maybe Cuevas go in for him. Ooh. So Cuevas is going to run basically for himself. So both teams have lost DH now. Little comedy there from Coach Wise. Said, hang on, let me make sure that my center fielder is going to still be in the game. My center fielder just died coming out of the dugout, I think is what he said. Nonetheless, he is good. He is ready to go. Cuevas now running at first base. Professor Briggs, I know you're loving it. Both Mohawk and Ellwood City have lost a DH. So Cuevas now running at first. Will Nardone will step to the plate, 0-3 today. And he's going to go. First pitch swinging, throw down to second base will be. Not sure if it was in time the first time, but it was for sure on the overslide. Caught stealing is Cuevas to end the inning on the base pass. Last chance time coming now for Mohawk. 4-3 they trailed. To the bottom of the seventh we go. Back in a moment on Lawrence County SportsNet. Before we start the bottom of the seventh inning, we have a final score from Neshanic, a 3-0 lead, a 3-0 victory for Neshanic, and they still have not allowed a run in section play all year long. That rematch comes on Friday, by the way. So it feels like baseball where you have the back-to-back games. Well, we get to check that one out on Friday for game two, Laurel and Neshanic softball. Here, a barn burner in game two of this series, Mohawk trailing 4-3. As we head to the bottom of the seventh inning, and they will have 8-9-1 hitters due up. And we'll see if it is going to be Nail, Hopper, and Fadden who are coming to the plate. And it is not. We're going to have a pinch hitter, Cash Stratton. Cash Stratton is going to pinch hit to lead off the inning. Stratton, 1-for-4 in his four plate appearances on the season. Will pinch hit for Nail here in the bottom of the seventh. First pitch from Lake misses inside for ball one. So Nail singled in the third. Seen Stratton as a courtesy runner, now as a pinch hitter in the seventh, and he has a 2-0 count. Fourth inning of relief for Aaron Lake. That one down to the knees. Count now 2-1. Misses inside, nearly hits Stratton. 3-1. Remember, that is a tying run at the plate. That one gets away. Ball four, leadoff man on base. So the tying run is on. First walk issued by Ellwood City, and not the time to do it. There was a hit batsman earlier in the game, but that is the first walk issued. How about on the other side? Only one walk issued, though four hit batsmen by Jackson Chapman in relief. Keegan Hopper sacrificed in the third, singled in the fifth. Would not be surprised if he's trying to move a runner here. He is, pulls back, first pitch misses outside for ball one. Playing way in is Kennedy at third base. He's about 60 feet away. There's the bunt on the first baseline. A beauty. It will stay fair. And there would be the tag out. Three unassisted on the tag from Will Nardone. But the sacrifice executed perfectly. Now the tying run is in scoring position. And the top of the order coming to bat. Exactly what you're looking for if you're Mohawk. And now Ellwood City coach Chris Wise is going to go to the mound for another LGKG consultation. It cannot always be night. While we have a moment, give a shout out to our powering sponsor, the Lawrence County Community Action Partnership. If you've ever wanted an exciting career working with children, well, LCAP Early Learning is looking for you. You can apply today at lcap.org/join our team. That's lccap.org/join our team. Big day of events down at Neshanic today. Newcastle and Neshanic baseball teams playing. Neshanic softball just defeated Laurel 3-0. Also a track meet going on there. Our friends from Summing Through Wall Photography are going to have plenty of pictures from that one. Glad to give you the sights and sounds here at Mohawk High School as Bobby Fadden comes to the plate with one down and watches the first pitch miss downstairs for ball one. Fadden, three ground outs in the game. A 286 hitter on the year. Four-sport athlete, along with his cousin, J. Michael Rona, who stands in the on-deck circle. Lake kicks, delivers. Off the end of the bat, a flare towards left, and it's going to hang up in the air long enough for Biscup to settle under it. Looked good off the bat, but it just hung up enough, and Biscup had a track on it the whole way. Mohawk now down to their final out. Now the question is, with the YSU commit at the plate and an open base, how much are you going to throw at him? He's 0 for 3 with three ground outs on the day. First pitch breaking ball misses outside. But the reason why you can't be too careful is he would be the winning run if he did get on the base pass. You still got A.J. Verdi, who's quite the hitter in the on-deck circle. 1-0 misses upstairs as well, 2-0. The count. Lake kicks, delivers, down in the pebbles, trying to go to third, throw down, is gonna be wide. And reading the ball in the dirt the whole way, Stratton, the pinch runner, is going to get. I don't know what the discussion is. I think they might be asking, could Rona have technically interfered? He was still in the box, so no obstruction could be called. So now a 3-0 count. Going from the windup is Lake. Catches the top of the zone, 3-1. Lake winds and fires. 3-1 pitch. Another flare towards the left center gap. This one's going to get down. We got a tie ball game. And now Rona going into second base. J. Michael Rona extends the game with his sixth RBI of the season. And with that as well, he's on second base, runner in scoring position. They're intentionally walking Verdi. And Vinny Pizzullo, and he's shown his bat today, a couple of long balls. A double off the wall for an RBI double in the fourth. But that is the speedy Jay Rona, the YSU commit, who is standing at second base as the potential winning run. Pizzullo, 1 for 3 on the day. Breaking ball catches the top of the zone for strike one. Pizzullo, the winning pitcher yesterday. Single here would likely mean a victory and Mohawk staying atop the section standings. Breaking ball misses inside, evens the count at 1-1. Rona at second. Verdi running for himself, by the way, at first. Ground ball left side. Taken there by Kennedy. Throw is wide, and he's not going to get back in time. Throw back to third base, sliding back in, feet first is Rona. He's safe. Everybody's safe. Bases are full of Warriors. That one's going to have to go down as an E5 on the errant throw. Putting Pizzullo on the bases. Aiden Bowser will re-enter. There is a pinch runner, Drew Runner for him. Can he go click, click, boom? And remember, too, now with Rona at third, every pitch crucial to make sure it stays in front. From the windup, beautiful breaking ball, but it misses just downstairs for ball one. The 1-0, that one also outside. Didn't miss by much, but it hasn't been a strike all day. 2-0 now the count. There, well, Rona getting a huge lead at third base with late going from the wind. The 2-0, this one does catch the outside corner, 2-1. Bowser, 1-for-3. This one well outside, 3-1 now the count, and nowhere to put him. Rona at third, Verdi at second, Pizzullo at first, Aiden Bowser, a 3-1 count coming his way. This is upstairs, the walk-off walk. Mohawk is victorious. The second time in the last 3 years that the Warriors have walked it off at home against the Wolverines. Your final score here from Mohawk High School, Warriors 5, Ellwood City 4. We'll be back to recap it all when we return. It's the Lawrence County SportsNet powered by LCAP.
Tired of gasoline costs? Why drive? Let the Newcastle Transit Authority take you where you want to go. Serving the city of Newcastle and stops throughout Lawrence County, as well as weekday service to Pittsburgh. Public transportation just makes sense. Why drive when you can relax and ride? For more information or for route schedules, log on to newcastletransit.org. The Newcastle Transit Authority, going your way. And remember, senior citizens ride free.
Castle Asphalt and Construction is driven to provide quality, cost-efficient pavement-related services to Western Pennsylvania. Every paving or construction service at Castle Asphalt begins with a thorough site inspection of the area to allow their team of professionals to become familiar with the unique conditions of your home or business. Once the site inspection is complete, Castle Asphalt provides you with a detailed plan of the design, cost, materials, and time of completion so you know exactly what to expect during your construction. Visit castleasphalt.com to request a quote for your next project and make your dream design come to fruition.
For 20 years, Mele Chiropractic has treated athletes of all ages to help them get safely back to the top of their game. Mele Chiropractic has 3 full-time doctors in their office, and all 3 are former area athletes who have had to battle injuries throughout their careers. They want to help you get safely back on your feet. But more importantly, help stop the injuries before they happen. Prehab before you rehab.
Attention all high school student athletes. During your sports season, a $30 visit to the Mele Chiropractic office includes an adjustment and or all therapy is necessary.
From the athletes of tomorrow to the weekend warriors and everything in between. Let Mele Chiropractic keep you in the game.
When it comes to shopping for insurance, there are thousands of options out there. MVP Insurance proactively shops and compares your policies to find the best coverage and rate. Josh Mathur and David Verratti want to provide you with the level of personalized service that you know that you are the MVP of their agency. They simplify insurance so you can live stress-free. Visit one of the locations in Xenoleopol or in New Springfield, Ohio. Call MVP for the win. Proud sponsor of the MVP of the game on the Lawrence County SportsNet.
Just like going to the doctor, our homes need a checkup too. If your home is not properly weatherized, you could be at risk for symptoms that cause unhealthy ailments and higher utility bills. The Weatherization Assistance Program is the key to reducing utility costs and increasing comfort in your home. Services include an in-home energy audit to inspect your furnace and hot water tank, check for air sealing around windows and doors, and ensure adequate insulation and ventilation. Learn more at LCAP.org or call the Department of Healthy Homes to get your checkup today.
Lawrence County SportsNet is proud to honor Giovanni Valentine of Neshanic Hockey as the March LGKG Male Athlete of the Month after leading the Lancers to a PIHL championship. LC SportsNet is also proud to honor Alexis Brewer of Laurel Wrestling as the March LGKG Red Zone Female Athlete of the Month for her journey through the consolation bracket to a PIAA 7th place finish. Congratulations and best of luck to Neshanic's Gio Valentine and Laurel's Alexis Brewer, the LGKG Athletes of the Month, presented by the Red Zone. Congratulations to our March LCAP Team of the Month. The Lawrence County SportsNet is proud to honor Neshanic Hockey as the March LCAP Team of the Month after winning their third PIHL championship in the last 4 years. Congratulations to Coach Mark Molteri and the Neshanic Hockey Team, your March LCAP Team of the Month.
More and more, people are consuming information on screens. Businesses that want to engage, educate, or entertain clients are turning to Toshiba to provide inspired communication with digital signage experiences that attract attention in novel and entertaining ways. Information needs to be managed to be effective, and organizations can trust Toshiba to provide solutions for improved workflow, which help to securely store, organize, and manage information, whether in digital or physical form. Toshiba, empowering the art of business. Business communication must be agile, efficient, and fast. Toshiba is the company that helps you manage it all, from paper to digital to screen and back again. With smarter printing, you are unleashed. The office is wherever you are, and Toshiba makes it seamless to print whatever, wherever, and whenever. Our mobile printing applications allow you to print or scan to both Toshiba and third-party MFPs right from your mobile device. Toshiba, empowering the art of business.
Looking for a unique way to expand your business? Advertise on the Lawrence County SportsNet and be seen by thousands of viewers in the area and around the country on over 100 broadcasts each year. Visit lcsportsnet.com and click Advertise with LCSN.
Tri County Principals postgame show here on the Lawrence County SportsNet, powered by LCAP. And a crazy exciting one here as Mohawk scores two in the bottom of the seventh inning to walk it off. A walk-off walk drawn by Aiden Bowser to get the win 5-4, and they remain unbeaten as a result in section play. I'm James Dotson. Man, it's been a fun one here, to say the very least. We'll get you the full recap going here in a moment. First, want to get the line score all straightened away. Give us 1 second here, folks. Yeah, there we go. All right, so let's bring up your line score so you can see the final numbers. Mohawk victorious with that 5-4 score line. Let's get you our scoring summary, your scoring recap. It's brought to you by Creative Edge, where design and construction come together with experience. Call 724-652-1372 for more information. From concept to creation, they create extensive construction experience with creative design to help make the visions for your project a reality. Ellwood City got things rolling in the third inning. Leadoff single from Jacob Biscup. He stole second and then scored on an RBI double to right field, an opposite field double for Isaiah Lutz. Made the score 1-0 Ellwood City. Lutz would then score on an RBI single with two outs. Or excuse me, yeah, that was a one-out RBI single, excuse me, by Aaron Lake.
Thank you, sir.
Made the score 2-0, and Lake would later score on an errant throw to first base. Made the score 3-0 at the end of three innings. Mohawk able to get their runs in the fourth. A one-out double from A.J. Verdi. He switched places with Pizzullo, hits his own moonshot double off the wall in left center field. Made the score 2-1, and then Pizzullo would score on a two-out single from Jackson Chapman to get the score down to 3-2. Big play in the sixth inning as Bishop ends up driving in a run. Kennedy hit by a pitch with two outs. Landis with a single to turn the lineup over, and Bishop getting his third hit of the day. RBI single made it 4-2. A little insurance, Mohawk, good job getting it back. Verdi led off the inning, got hit. His courtesy runner, Swanson, would later score on a single. Or excuse me, it wasn't on the single. Ended up being first and third, and Drew Rohner went to steal second. The throw went into center field, excuse me, and that allowed the runner to score from third, made it 4-3. Ellwood City couldn't get any more. They were retired in order in the top of the seventh. J.J. Nails, pinch hitter, Cash Stratton, leads off with a walk and then ends up sacrificed to second by Hopper. Fadden flew out. J. Rohner then hits a fly ball, a double to left field to get the tying run in. He now represents the winning run. They intentionally walk Verdi. Pizzullo reaches on an error, and then Bowser draws the bases-loaded walk, his fifth RBI of the year, scoring Rohner from third to end your ball game 5-4 is the final score. Four runs, six hits, two errors, eight runners left on for Ellwood City, five runs, eight hits, two errors, and four runners left on the bases for the Mohawk Warriors. 8-1, they somehow find a way. They've done it so many times, especially against Ellwood City. They've done it a couple times in the last 3 years now is what's been the absolute craziest. And hats off to Ellwood City. They always are a tough team. They're never an easy out, no matter what the scenario is. They came to play today, and the only two walks issued by Ellwood City all game, one was the leadoff walk that became tying run in the bottom of the seventh inning. The other one drove in the winning run to end the ball game. A couple news and notes. How about a 3-for-3 day for Jacob Bishop at the plate? Huge performance for him on the day. On base all four times, actually, was Bishop. On base three times in the game was Aaron Lake. He went 1-for-2, a walk and a hit batsman as well. The winning pitcher ends up being Jackson Chapman, pitched four innings of relief, gave up one run. It was earned on two hits, struck out two, didn't walk any, but he did hit four batters in the game, but he gets the win in relief. Combined with the 2-for-3 day and an RBI at the plate, Jackson Chapman is your MVP insurance, MVP of the game. Congratulations, Jackson Chapman. He receives his customized T-shirt courtesy of the Red Zone in recognition of being tonight's MVP insurance, MVP of the game. You can view the full list of MVPs as we get them updated here at going at lcsportsnet.com. Click on MVP of the game. Congratulations again, Jackson Chapman, for being tonight's MVP of the game. Call MVP for the win. A couple nominations. There were some great plays all around. The double play by Ellwood City was impressive. A couple of great plays by Bobby Fadden in the middle of the infield, including a nifty 4-6-3 double play. But in the end, game-winning play. You got to give it to Aiden Bowser. He draws the walk-off walk. He receives the Melee Chiropractic play of the game. He will also get a customized T-shirt, courtesy of the Red Zone, in recognition of being tonight's Melee Chiropractic Play of the Game Award recipient. Congratulations, Aiden Bowser, your Melee Chiropractic Play of the Game. Let Melee Chiropractic keep you in the game. We're holding here to see if we can try to get either Coach Mariano or maybe Chap to come up. You know what, with that, we're just, I think, going to wrap things up here and let the Mohawk Warriors enjoy it. Try to catch a couple of players on the way out. They're enjoying their time. Try to catch Coach Mariano for a quick word as well. We'll let them enjoy. Again, this is the third or second walk-off, at least, in the last 3 years against Ellwood City. We've, unfortunately for Ellwood fans, we've had the coverage of it the last couple of years here. Still well within it, still plenty of games to be played for sure. The big one they still have coming up, their makeup game in section against Quaker Valley coming up on Thursday, weather permitting, will be a big one for sure. And then the next series coming up for the Ellwood City Wolverines will be against Beaver Falls. They actually have their off week next week, then Beaver Falls and Chenango to end it. That Chenango series is probably going to be the way it's looking, potentially for that final spot in the playoffs. I mean, the top four teams in section play will make the playoffs. That's assuming Ellwood City is able to take care of business and get the official sweep over Quaker Valley. Mohawk, they take on Beaver Falls next week before finishing with Chenango and Riverside. So big series the rest of the way for both of these squads. We'll have coverage of all of it best as we can here on the Lawrence County SportsNet powered by LCAP. Thanks again to Matt Flannery, our producer, taking care of all the tech stuff on this side. Big thanks again to Mr. Pizzullo. Didn't get a chance to even show it, so we're going to do it real quick. We're going to do a little pan to the to the inside of the press box. They built this just in the last week, this little extra level behind us of all the tech and gizmos and everything. Yeah, that's all our stuff, but on an extra platform up there. Big thanks to them for doing that. Huge thanks to everything that they do for us. Matt Laporte, for not being ejected for coaching a team he no longer is associated with. But big thanks to him, as always. Always very hospitable to us. And they're getting all everything set up so we can be back behind home plate for the softball game coming up on Monday. We'll be here for the Mohawk Ellwood City softball game as well. Your final score one last time, a 5-4 walk-off win for Mohawk to remain unbeaten in section play. I'm James Dotson saying so long and stay tuned. Thanks for joining. We'll see you soon here on the Lawrence County SportsNet powered by LCAP. You have a great night, everyone.
Your voice for Lawrence County Sports.
The gold ball headed home to Newcastle.
This is the Lawrence County Sports.